What we really intended to do with the Hyperloop was really to spur interest in new forms of transportation. It's clear that the public and the world want something new. We want to bring this to fruition and show people that something new and great can happen, and it doesn't have to be the same old thing. And I think you guys are going to bring it to them. Yeah.
Hyperloop is a fifth mode of transportation. You have cars, boats, trains, planes. It's a high-speed transportation that fits people within a tube, and you can get from A to B in a very short amount of time.
HyperXite is a student project to prove that the Hyperloop concept could be a reality in the future, and it's part of a competition being put on by SpaceX.
The Hyperloop can take you from LA to San Francisco in 35 minutes. This mode of transportation can go close to the speed of sound. So it's pretty exciting. We're making a scaled version of what we believe will be the Hyperloop.
It's a big day today. We're about to do the layup. It took us many months to get here. It's going to be an exciting day. Successfully finished laying up two molds, and the moment of truth will be in 4 to 5 days. We're going to demold the parts and we'll see how it went.
Touch down. Bring it in. Take it home. Go.
Ooh. It's been a huge learning process because we've basically designed something from the ground up.
Every single part on this pod has been machined by either our students or the help of our sponsors.
We've done this entirely from scratch. We went from just a design to an entirely constructed pod in such a short amount of time.
Everything's been put together by the students, and this is an all-undergrad team.
I'm afraid that we might break the flange before we take this out.
I don't think it's gonna come out like this. Today's the day we're actually demolding our bottom side of the mold, so we'll find out what the surface actually looks like.
Bring it in this towards me. There it is. Oh! Came out better than I thought it would. For the first 14-foot layup like this, it's not that bad.
All around.
We have our own unique design. We have air levitation, which most teams are actually using magnetic levitation.
3, 2, 1. The reason we decided to do this is because it's never been done before, and we wanted to explore something new.
3, 2, 1, go.
Why not take on a challenge? We can follow the status quo and go magnetic levitation where we know it works, or why not go air lev and prove whether or not it can or cannot work.
One of the goals is to win this competition, but there's another goal in that we're collecting information to allow companies in the future to build a full-scale Hyperloop at a lower cost, because we'll have done some of that preliminary research. It's also just a project for students to learn more about how to be engineers.
It's crazy to see that we're here now. The day has finally come. We've been waiting a long time for this moment, doing our last minute touches, and we'll be heading to SpaceX.
I'm extremely proud of them. I mean, they have really worked tirelessly, and I have only the utmost respect for the quality of the work they have done and the time they have put into it.
The fact that undergrad students could come together dealing with school and their own life and be able to make something this big is incredible.
About a year ago, this was all on paper. So seeing it now as a physical thing, it's very humbling, I think, and it's just amazing.
We want the Hyperloop to become a reality. It would join cities together. It would change the world.
There's a future. Like, I can't see actually Hyperloop being in this country, and then people will use it. And then one day I'm going to be like, oh, I remember that was my senior project. I actually worked on it.